an awful big lost and found under the circumstances. It wasn't fixed, it was unbroken. Service for all the men and women who serve Ceylandia. That's the way to make every shot count. Even the army never issued carbines in such fine shape. It's no longer a weapon, it's a precision instrument. The shards are getting harder to find. Ceylandia's army only took the best, and the best of them trained on Trigger Hill. The Triggers believed they were nothing without their rifles. Nothing beats the feel of shooting a Ceylandian army carbine. You had to take care to steady your shot. The Triggers had clearance to modify their guns however they chose. Some felt the course was too easy, so the Triggers spiced things up a bit. Kid blows through that course like it was nothing. The Ceylandian army would have recruited him in a flash. The Triggers, my brothers, bravest men I ever knew. Kid arrives just in time to sample Zia's famous cooking. Sometimes a brusher's pike just ain't enough. That's what the carbine's for. Gotta make sure the pointy end's fastened on real tight. Nothing makes a gun so dangerous as a keen eye. You'd never guess those things been to the wilds and back. Leechade's so sour it'll perk you right up when you're feeling low. He wolfs down too much too fast, and it all goes to his head. I've said a lot about the kid, but he ain't the only one wrapped up in all this. What's he thinking? Well, let me see if I got this straight. I only heard it once. Once there was a normal Ura girl. But she wasn't born in the Tazzil terminals like the rest of her people. She was from Ceylonia. Folks were orphaned in the war, taken in and raised inside the city, on condition they would never return to the terminals. Well, you know how it goes. Ura refugees who came into the city had to stay for life. It was a way to reduce the risk of city secrets leaking out. Mama passed away from birthing complications, leaving the girl trapped inside that city with no one but her father. Father was sharper than a brusher's pike, so he got a job working for the city's mancers. His daughter barely saw him. Father told her nothing of her Ura heritage. He told her nothing of the Mancers. It's for your own good, he said. She took to studying the arts, learned more through music than history books, gained a knack for strings and songs. First, she tried to be like other girls, but her classmates spread word that her father was an Ura trader, selling out the city. One young man stood up for her, or so he led her to believe. He knew much of her heritage, and she grew fond of him. Oh. young man convinced her to take him to a family den to meet her father. Spoke of how he wanted to meet a man from the terminals. The young man greeted her father in the Ura's native language. Her father flew into a fit of rage and threw them out. The young man never told her that the Ura's native language is not to be used by foreigners. To do so is a terrible insult. What's the use? It was then that she decided to escape. The two of them could flee the city together and go to the Tazzil terminals. They would hide inside a garbage bin until it got ingested by a scumbag. Then let him slosh on out of the city for disposal. But the authorities were already there when that scumbag sidled up to the city walls. The young man had sent the authorities a tip, told him her father was using her to sell secrets to the Tazzil terminals. She and her father were arrested for treason, but her father got a deal. Returned to work for the Mansers, and she'd go free.
Gonna build that city on a hill.
Before they parted ways for the last time, her father whispered a desperate plea. Hurry home to the den and lock yourself in.
Build that wall up to the sky.
Father's hand. When the kid wakes up, his world's still in pieces, just the way he left it.